The UK Geoenergy Observatory in Glasgow is an underground laboratory for research and innovation into mine water heat and heat storage. The observatory enables research on using warm water within abandoned coal mine workings to provide renewable heating for homes and businesses. This public facility is part of the UK Geoenergy Observatory's project, which aims to deliver essential new data from the subsurface. It includes observatories in Glasgow and Cheshire, an online data portal, and a core scanning facility. Like many towns and cities across the UK, much of the city of Glasgow lies above abandoned coal mine workings. Mine water energy could become a key part of decarbonised heating and storage and contribute towards meeting our net zero targets.
We're here in the Cuningar Loop Park, and the observatory is based here because underneath our feet there are a number of different abandoned coal mine workings that came from the farm colliery in Rutherglen. We need new ways to heat our homes and our buildings in low carbon ways. Mine water heat and heat storage is one way that we may be able to do that. And this observatory will enable us to look at the risks, impacts, processes of that technology under the ground. And it's a new way of using our old abandoned mine workings towards the energy transition and low carbon energy sources.
At the Glasgow Observatory, 12 boreholes monitor the subsurface. There are 6 boreholes fitted with a network of sensors which penetrate the abandoned flooded mine workings at depths of between 50 and 85 metres below the surface. There are also 5 environmental monitoring boreholes and a seismic monitoring borehole situated 1.5 kilometres to the west.
Sites 1, 2 and 3 are our main sites, and they comprise of 2 mine water geothermal boreholes. If we look to my left, you'll see a manhole cover. This is borehole GGAO7. It is drilled to a depth of about 50 metres and it's screened across the Glasgow Upper, which is one of the extensive mine workings in this area. So the second borehole, the mine water borehole on this site, is GGAO8. This is screened across the Glasgow Main, which is one of the deeper mine workings in the area. Our third borehole, which is right over by the fence, this borehole has a very special purpose. It's part of our environmental monitoring borehole data set. Coming back to our mine water boreholes, they are highly sensored. Both GGAO7, GGAO8, and the other 3 mine water boreholes have got ERT, or electrical resistivity tomography sensors, attached to the outside of the casing. We also have fibre optic cables. These distributed temperature sensors will provide a temperature profile down along the borehole. On site 1, we have an INSAR active reflector. This measures, by use of radar via satellites, any ground deformation. We have soil gas probes to measure changes in soil gases on all of the compounds. We are going to get scanning lasers installed, which will measure changes in gases which are more atmospheric.
A range of sensors within the boreholes and samples from the groundwater allow scientists to study the physical, chemical and biological changes within the subsurface and understand more about the size and sustainability of the heat resource. Initial testing has proved high yields of mine water at around 12 degrees centigrade. The 199 metre deep seismic monitoring borehole has 5 downhole seismometers which contribute data to the UK National Monitoring Network. Rock core of an unmined section of the Carboniferous coal measures was recovered from this borehole and forms a geological reference section. Downhole logs are also openly available. The 5 environmental baseline boreholes were drilled into the bedrock and superficial deposits above the mine. These boreholes characterise and monitor ongoing environmental change and help us understand subsurface to surface impacts.
Today we've been collecting mine water for doing sampling back at the labs to actually do baseline monitoring of the boreholes so we can understand what the baseline conditions are continuously throughout an extended period of time. The data from the mines from the data log is collected monthly, and then the ERT and the fiber optics information is collected through the mobile networks continuously and also stored on site, so can also be downloaded when needed as well.
The conductivity sensors, when we download it monthly, we process the data, and then we're working on putting it onto the UK Geos website, where it will be free to download for anyone there.
In the very near future, we will be installing some more infrastructure to bring it into a small-scale geothermal research laboratory. Two of the boreholes will be used as abstraction boreholes, and two will be used as injection. There will be a series of pipes which will join all three sites together, running from site 2 via site 3 and into site 1. On site 1, which is our largest site, we will have a heat unit which will include heat exchangers and a chiller.
The Glasgow Observatory will improve the open evidence base on any environmental impacts of mine water heat schemes. Environmental monitoring data, including soil chemistry, ground gas, surface water geochemistry, and ground motion datasets, are already available online.
The UK Geoenergy Observatory in Glasgow is a really important and innovative project because it's an at-scale underground laboratory that's at the scale of a small mine water energy scheme. It's much more complex than the laboratory situation, yet because we don't have a heat user, the site is very flexible to do lots of different research, experiments, develop technology and so on. We're really keen to hear from researchers who would like to use the observatory, from geoscientists to environmental scientists to geoengineers, whether they're from academia, from commercial companies, or from government organisations.
The boreholes and research compounds are available for scientists and industry to use and test sensors, take measurements, and add to the growing body of evidence that heat from our old coal mines and storage capacity within them could form part of clean energy from the earth in our transition to net zero. For more information on the UK Geoenergy Observatories and to access the data portal, please visit ukgeos.ac.uk.